So this I just wanted to brief you. It's just not a story, it's a true story. So it's a story about the Prashant, a person visits Erasama and coming of the storm. Prashant went to his friend's house in Erasama on 22nd October 1999. It was 7 years after his mother's death. So he was from Odisha. So 7 years after his mother's death, he had been there. In evening, heavy and continuous rain filled with darkness. Trees were uprooted. The waters entered his friend's house. The speed of the wind was 350 kilometers per hour. Okay, so we start reading. September 27, 1999, 7 years after his mother's death, Prashant had gone to the block headquarters of Erasama, a small town in coastal Odisha, some 18 kilometers from his village, to spend the day with a friend. In the evening, a dark and menacing storm quickly gathered. Winds beat against the houses with a speed and fury that Prashant had never witnessed before. Heavy and incessant rain filled the darkness. Ancient trees were uprooted and crashed to the earth. Screams rent the air as people and houses were swiftly washed away. The angry waters swirled into his friend's house neck deep. The building was of brick and mortar and was strong enough to survive the devastation of the wind's velocity of 350 kilometers per hour. But the cold terror of the family grew with the crashing of trees that had got uprooted and fallen on their house. Sometime in the middle of the night, damaging its roofs and walls. The crazed destruction wrought by the Sablin and the surge of the ocean continued for the next 36 hours. Although wind speeds had reduced somewhat by the next morning to escape the waters rising in the house, Prashant and his friend's family had taken refuge on the roof. Prashant will never forget the shock he experienced at his first glimpse of the devastation wrought by the super cyclone. In the grey light of the early morning, a raging, deadly brown sheet of water covered everything as far as the eye could see. Only fractured cement houses stood in a few places. Bloated animal carcasses and human corpses floated in every direction. All round, even huge old trees had fallen. Two coconut trees had fallen on the roof of their house. This was a blessing in disguise, because the tender coconuts from the trees kept the trapped family from starving in the several days that followed. We'll keep it till there. Several days we followed, we'll keep it till there. We'll come back in the next class and I'll explain. So because I need more time and just we cannot rush through. So you'll read till there and try to understand the impact. Go back into and try to search what happened during that time. Okay? So be good, stay safe. Stay home, love your parents, respect them, and have a disciplined life. Jai Hind, happy Independence Week. Bye bye.